Karibu tena, unaendelea kutazama Citizen Town Hall, tuko katika dakika za lala salama, lakini kabla ya kumalizia tunataka kuwapatia nafasi watu kadha wa kadha waweze kuuliza maswali yao ili yaweze kujibiwa tukifunga kipindi chetu. Hazael, tuanze na wewe.
Thank you so much. My name is Hazael Kogei, a student in Catholic University of Eastern Africa, Langata campus. I have a question to herbalist Mr. Martin. Mr. Martin, since we don't have a medical regulatory body that regulates a medical herb in the country, how do you know the bioactivity or bioavailability of the drug so that you can regulate the amount that is supposed to be given to certain or different types of diseases? Thank you so much.
Thank you. Na nadhani hiyo pia it boils down to the prescription. Ukienda kwa pharmacy unaambiwa kunywa tembe moja mara tatu kwa siku. Je, kwa miti shamba inakuaje? Lakini hebu sasa nimpatie nafasi Masi Murugi aweze kuuliza swali lake.
Thank you for the question, for the opportunity. My name is Masi Murugi. My question is to the herbalists. When you prescribing something for an ailment, how do you know the composition? Because when it comes to modern medicine, we're told it consists this and this. And also another question is, how do you know the side effects that will occur in someone? And also when it comes to women who are pregnant, how do you know? And do you also get to know the medical history of the person so that to avoid harm to that person leading to what you'll prescribe? Thank you.
Asante sana Masi, swali zito hapo. Hebu sasa nimpatie mzee mmoja nafasi aweze kuuliza swali lake, hatujafahamiana lakini atatuambia jina lake.
My name is Sami Kirui. Swali langu kwa Martin ni kwamba ulisema wewe mwenyewe ni lab. Unaweza kutuambia ni aina miti ngapi ambayo umejijaribia mwenyewe ukajua inatibu nini?
Na asante sana. Swali lingine hapa.
My name is Walter Opio from Masai Mara University. I have one concern to the regulatory board. What are the measures you take? And also in case of a misprescription, who bears the responsibility? Thank you.
Asante sana. Wacha nipatiane nafasi ya mwisho hapa kwa kijana mmoja aweze kutumalizia.
Thank you. My name is Okinyi Kevin from the University of Nairobi, and my question goes to Dr. Martin. And my question is, which criteria do you use when administering herbal medicine to your patient? And if so, do they have overdose? For example, for the case of my sister over there, the medicine that she was given by a friend, actually there were some side effects. So can you say it's an overdose or can you explain? Thank you.
Okay.
Wahiga.
So those are the questions. I think, Dr. Waraka, let's start with you. You've had some of the questions. Start with the ones you would like to tackle.
There's a challenge here and a dilemma in that this country, like you said, when I went to India for surgery, do some surgery, I was invited a bit at Max Hospital. Their pharmacy also kept Ayurvedic medicine. Mm-hmm. Ayurvedic medicine is also alternative medicine. Alternative medicine could be plant medicine, could be there are all kinds of different types away from the conventional medicine that we use. So in those countries, like Peter said, there is they've already done so much research, they're so ahead. They know exactly what they're giving and what results could be. We have a problem because in this country we have not yet done those studies to the level where we can be sure. We have not standardized, and I think that is true. I think Martin would elaborate on that because in the herbal side, but the way I see it is there's got to be a collaboration. We have to start talking. Maybe a conference has to come between the conventional doctors, the alternative doctors, complementary researchers like Kemri, pharmacology, And also a general audience who want to come forward, so we sit together and talk, bring out what we have so that we can now go forward and see what we can do. But there is a challenge at the moment, in my opinion.
In your opinion, are you not afraid that some of your patients, tired of not getting the resource, the conventional medicine, will run away from conventional medicine and go and try the alternatives and suffer?
Oh, well.
Because you said, give it, it might work.
You see, the fear, I don't have fear. What I have is the fact that we as professionals, all of us together, are failing to communicate to the public.
Okay.
And we're probably taking too long and they're moving faster than us. Social media, and there's a lot of education going on everywhere else now. So we have to move fast, come up with all this and educate our people so they can now know what to do. This is what I see, because if we stand there without 60% of the people, according to some studies that I saw somewhere in the country, actually go to a traditional doctor first before they even come to you. Some of them are using both of you, so without telling them. So there is that area of mystery is not being tackled rapidly by us as professionals and the government and so forth and so on.
So
we have to act now before it is too late.
Before it is too late. Yeah. Martin, umeulizwa maswali mengi sana. Sijui utaanza na gani?
Kuna nyingine ambayo singependa ipite. Kwanza nianze na mambo ya cannabis sativa. Okay, vile ameleza ndio ni dawa. Kwamba unapata wale wanaitumia kwa jeye ile sio halali. Anasema wale wenye walikuwa na isifu, wenye walikuita dawa uliwatibu. Wenye walikuita kimbilio ulikimbilia na wao. Kwa hivyo inategemea jinsi unaitumia. Nimeletea mgonjwa ambaye alitumia mitishamba sana sana cannabis sativa, of which sio mimi nilimpatia, alipewa na mwingine. So inategemea jinsi ameitumia. Cannabis sativa ukiwakisha na moto, hiyo nguvu iko nayo inabadilika. Linakuwa mbaya sasa kwa maisha yako. Lakini kama mimi najua cannabis sativa ni painkiller ya magonjwa yote kwa mwili. Kwa hivyo unaitumia kama painkiller wakati umeitengeza vile livyo bila kuipitisha kwa moto. Hiyo ni cannabis sativa.
Okay.
Okay, nikijibu swali lingine. Waliuliza vile itajua ndiposa nipate certificate ya kuwa kuhusu kufanya kazi ya miti shamba. Lazima uchukue miti kadha wa kadha upeleke kwa sampling.
Mm-hmm.
Of which ndio kuwe certified, lazima miti zako yonekane, hii ime chemical content yake ni hii na hii na hii. Of which yoyote nilifanya, nikakuwa certified mwaka wa 2004.
Certified by company gani? Or?
Kwa Ministry of Culture wakati huo.
Oh, Ministry of Culture.
Ministry of
okay.
Culture.
Okay.
Yes. Kwa hivyo sasa hapo before nifike hapo lazima madawa zangu zipite pale kwa laboratory waziangalie. Mimi mwenyewe siziangalii. Hiyo nafuata hivyo sababu ya sheria zile ziko.
Mm-hmm.
Clear dosage ya miti shamba haiko. Kwamba sema miti hii utatumia hivi na hivi. Mimi kulingana hekima niko nayo,
mm-hmm,
najua mtu mzima asipitishe glasses mbili na sio kwa kila dawa. Kuna madawa ile wezi pitisha hata glasi moja kwa siku. Na hiyo
okay,
akili yangu naitumia na inafanya kazi.
Okay, okay.
Okay,
ya mwisho tafadhali, okay, endelea.
Ya mwisho, mwenzangu pale ameuliza madawa gani yale nimeyatumia. Ni mengi, siwezi taja yote. Ya kwanza kabisa ile nitataja inaitwa Withania somnifera. Withania somnifera nimetumia ku increase sexual libido. Inami. Obisasa niko sawa. Kwa hivyo
dawa ni mengi. Kuuliza maswali mengine lakini unaweza maliza uko unasema?
Okay, nasema madawa ni mengi. So hiyo ni baadhi yale madawa nimetumia na niko na experience, na nikipata mteja wa aina hiyo najua vile napambana naye. Madawa kama Artemisia imetumika na inajulikana. Hiyo ni baadhi ya madawa yale natumia. But kumalizia kabisa, niko Best Museum. Kile nafanya pale ni kufacilitate on medicinal plants kwa garden pale at the museum.
Okay.
Yes.
Asante sana Martin. Professor Orwa, you had some questions you wanted to tackle.
Yes.
Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. There was a question on curriculum. I know it was not directed to me, but I just want to make one statement. You know, I am glad today we are talking about medicinal plants, herbal medicine, because if we are talking about traditional medicine, this is a wide area which we cannot demystify everything through scientific models. But medicinal plants, indeed, we have the capacity to verify all the claims by our traditional healers. So at the pharmacy school, there is a topic, a subject which is taught to the pharmacists known as pharmacognosy. So pharmacognosy is actually the study of medicinal plants, and this is already in the curriculum. So this is why I would probably say you find most pharmacists are okay with medicinal plants compared to our conventional doctors who do not pass through any stage of knowing about medicinal plants. So we do pharmacognosy, we do pharmacology, and this is actually a good start for using medicinal plants. If I can talk about, I know he has answered how you can get the dosage. Traditional medicine has been used for a very, very long time. And our great, great grandfathers used intuition. They knew what to do,
okay,
what to take, how much to measure. So from there, and that is why in Khemri we try to work with the dosages from the traditional doctors. But of course, through research, we need to standardize all these medication, find a proper dosage, and formulate either phytomedicines, which are not purified, because sometimes you find that if you take these plants and purify them and isolate pure compounds, then they lose activity. Mm-hmm. Because they need to work in combination and synergy. So that is something we need to note.
Okay.
Finally, I would like to say that somebody asked, how do I identify quacks or in traditional medicine and who is good?
Mm-hmm.
Big challenge. And that is why we need to document who are real traditional healers, verify their products through research, and then get them registered by the Ministry of Health.
Ministry of Health.
Because currently they are under the culture, and this is a culture, we agree. We have been using traditional medicine for a long time, and this is even accepted by the World Health Organization. So at that level where you use traditional medicine at the level of your household, you are actually titrating the dosages according to your patients. So this is allowed. But if you want to put your medicinal plants on the shelf where even the conventional doctors can prescribe, then it has to go through thorough preclinical, clinical studies.
Okay.
And then the doctor will know the composition of what they are actually prescribing.
Okay.
So that is the importance of actually doing research like we do in Cambridge.
Thank you for that. And Dr. Ikamati, I don't know if you have any more questions, so I'll take this as your last point. Yeah. As you reflect on what the audience has asked, when you look at the future of licensing of medicines in this country, what role will herbal play 5, 10, 15 years from now in your view? What would you predict? Can you ignore? Can anyone afford to ignore herbal medicines?
Well, we cannot ignore herbal medicines. As per now, the Pharmacy and Poisons Board has registered some of the herbal medicines.
Some of them.
But majority, most of them are from India, China, because they have data. They are backed with data. Currently in Kenya, very few people that have done research, and we're just registering them for minor ailments, like minor conditions for treatment of pain, treatment of fever, and these are things that can be found from literature that some of these plants they've been used outside the country, they've been used for these conditions. We can only do that, but there's a lot to be done. And as Kemri did the study and found out that some of the herbal medicines were manufactured or stored in an improper way, thus leading to microbial growth. I think the main thing that was there was microbial growth. The issue also is developing capacity in manufacturing of herbal medicines, and this is we call good manufacturing practice for the conventional medicines, the same case for herbal medicines. Medicines have to be manufactured in a clean environment in a way that assures that the product that comes out is of good quality, is of good efficacy and good safety. Another thing I'll mention, I've heard some of the audience and the panel talk about cannabis. Please note that bangi is not allowed in the country. So if you catch you with bangi, you'll get arrested. Yeah, some of the people have tried applying for licenses to grow marijuana for export. No, we've refused to offer such licenses. It is a great risk. Yes, cannabis has been studied extensively. Some cannabis is used. Some of the extracts are used for treatment. It can be used as an antiemetic. Some of the compounds, cannabinoids, they're used as antiemetics, particularly used for treatment of people that are receiving chemotherapy. Mm-hmm. So yes, it can be used as a drug, but it's an outlawed plant. In Kenya, you cannot, it's a banned plant, you cannot have it in Kenya. So if you're caught with an narcotics and control board or the pharmacy board, you'll be arrested and you lose all your assets. If they're found there, that is the narcotics law. Another thing,
okay, and briefly,
for
please.
For the products, herbal products, they have to be registered with the Pharmacy and Poisons Board. Mm-hmm. So currently what we've been doing in the last, I think you've seen in the last 1 month or so, some of the herbalists, we arrested and took to court some of the herbalists, and because some of them were mixing conventional medicines with traditional medicines, those are the people that we can call quacks, or people that have extensive claims.
Okay.
You cannot be treating so many diseases for something that you cannot prove. So products have to be registered with the Pharmacy and Poisons Board. If they're not, we'll arrest the people that are dealing with such products.
Thank you.
But taking cognizance that we need to develop this sector, that's why we are taking a multi-pronged approach, and we'll want to liaise with the research organizations and the stakeholders. We had a meeting with the herbalists some time back at the Pharmacy Board. We want to see how to develop the sector.
Okay, you want to see how to develop the sector?
Yes.
Thank you so much. I'll take that as your last word. That has been Dr. Peter Ikamati, Deputy Director, Directorate of Product Evaluation and Registration, Pharmacy and Poisons Board. He also is a World Health Organization consultant. Next to him, we also had Professor Jennifer Orwa, who is a fellow of the Pharmaceutical Society of Kenya and a research scientist, Kemri. Thank you for joining us. Martin Odhiambo, a herbalist who really had some interesting insights to share with us. Thank you for joining us today as well. And last but not least, we had Dr. Waraka Mwamlole, who's a consultant, a general surgeon. Thank you for joining us. Some of the guests we had invited on this show, by the way, we need to let you know, Professor Arthur Obel, a researcher, he of the famous HIV/AIDS drug. We had invited him for the program, but he did not join us for this show as well. And to all our audience here as well, thank you for finding time to be here with us. And those who are watching, we are seeing your messages. Tommy Sichemo says, at least 118 drugs are based on natural sources. 74% come from plants, 18% from fungi, 5% from bacteria, 3% from vertebrate species such as snakes or frogs. That is from a report released in 1997. While Phil Mwangi says, herbal medicine is the real deal. No chemicals in it. I've been using them since when I was a kid and they have worked. A single herb treats several diseases, but not all. Fascinating conversation that we need to take moving forward. If you missed our special report, Ghost of Loliondo Part 1 or Part 2, which aired today, you can catch that on YouTube as well. Sadly, all good things must come to an end, including our town hall. My name has been, or my name is, Wahiga Mwaura, and I'm not alone. Mashirima Kapombe is here as well.
Naam, nashukuru sana kwa kutupatia nafasi ya kututazama na kutuazima macho na masikio kusikiza mjadala wetu wa hii leo. Asante sana pia kwa hoteli ya Panare kwa kuweza kutupatia nafasi hii kuweza kukuletea kipindi hiki moja kwa moja ama mubashara kutoka hapa katika barabara kuu ya Mombasa Road. Mimi ni Mashirima Kapombe, kama ulikosa kwa Kiswahili makala hayo maalum ni Hekaya za Loliondo sehemu ya kwanza na ya pili, utapata kwenye YouTube yetu pamoja na view sasa.
Wapi makofi tafadhali. Thank you very much. Thank you to our panelists. Thank you to each.